Hello everyone, in this lecture we will be dealing with some basic questions of solid state chemistry, and basics in the sense that these questions can be calculated very easily without knowing the in-depth knowledge of a certain topic, right? And these are very easy questions, and this much you have studied in the BSc and as well as in the I would say in 12th class also. This is very easy, and but they do have a lot of weightage, so be careful in that. So this is a part 1 where I will deal with some easy questions. In the part 2 I will raise the level of the question, and in part 3 we will do some very hardcore questions. So let's start the video. In the first question, here we have been given d11. This d is nothing but the interplanar distance. Like in atoms we have n number of planes. So between two consecutive planes we have distance which is known as d, interplanar distance, okay. And what does that 111 means? This 111 is nothing but HKL values, HKL, okay, this is HKL. These are known as Miller indices. These can be calculated by taking reciprocal of intercept, but that's a different topic. I will make a dedicated video on that because it's a very important one. Okay, so these are in Miller indices. So this D11 value is given as 325.6 picometer, and we have to calculate for this 333 HKL values. Okay, so first of all write this. I am writing a general formula for the interplanar distance, which is given as 1 upon d square equals to right here h, k and l. And now write lattice parameters, which is a, b and c, and take the square of all of them and put plus sign. So this is a general formula for the interplanar distance, and 4 cubic. We have all the sides are equal, a equals to b equals to c. So this formula will become, when you will put here a, this will reduce to t equals to a upon root h square plus k square plus l square. This is a very basic mathematics, you can do by yourself. This is for cubic. Alright. So here we have been given cubic structure. Alright, so write directly for D11, this will become a upon root, this is HKL, so 1 square plus 1 square plus 1 square. So this is a upon root, how much? 3. So this is equation first. Now we have been asked for 333. So write here D333 equals to a upon root, this is h, so 3 square plus this is k, 3 square, and again l, 3 square. So this is a upon how much? This is 3 is a 9 plus 9 plus 9, 27. So this is equation second. Now just divide these two equations, so we will left with this is D111 upon D333 equals to a upon root 3, and this, when we will divide this one, this will become into multiplication. So this is root 27 upon a, so this cancels out and 3 9s are 27. So this will become D333 equals to D111 upon root 9 is 3. So this D11 is given as here 325.6. So write 325.6 upon 3. So 3 ones are 3. This will be around this value 308. Alright. So this will be around 308.5 picometer. So option C is the correct answer. Very easy. Just take these two equations and divide. Alright. Very basic mathematics. Now coming to the second question. Again, it is based on the interplanar distance. This is interplanar distance, which is represented as d. And this is a plane we have been given 100. This is HKL. Alright. And see, the structure is cubic. So for cubic, we have d equals to a upon root h square plus k square plus l square. So this is how much. And see here, the lattice parameter means sides have been given as 4 angstrom. So this is the value of a. So right here, 4 divided by root. This is HKL, 1 square plus 0 square plus 0 square. So this is 4 by root 1, which is 1. So this is 4 angstrom. So answer is C. Alright, very easy question. And these do comes many times in the CSIR examination. So let's quickly go to the next question. Again, a very basic question, and it came in the June 2012. So how many atoms are there in an element packed in a FCC structure? We know that in the class 12th we studied that in cubic we have z equals to 1, and in BCC body centered we have z equals to 2 and z equals to 4 in FCC. So 4 is the correct option. But for those who don't know how this came, I will tell you that in FCC, which is face centered cubic means atoms are present on corners and in the faces of the cube. So alright, are you getting my point? So in a cube we have 6 faces. Are you getting my point? And contribution equals to 1 by 2. These things I will take in a dedicated lecture, so don't worry about it for those who don't know, right? I will make a full-fledged video on this contribution, how many faces, how this comes, right? When I will make videos from the very, very basic concepts, alright? So in cube we have 6 faces. Let's say this is a cube. So this is one face, this is another, this is one face, and this is one. And one is behind and one is above. Right? This is a bit complicated to understand the 3D structure in a 2D manner. So maybe by the use of model I will make you understand. Okay. And corners, we have 8 corners, and the contribution is, we know that we have 8 corners. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, and 8. These corners. You can assume it as your room. Alright, your room is nothing but a cube. Alright, and the contribution is 1 by 8. So in FCC, we have atoms on corner plus face. How many corner are there? 8. Contribution is 1 by 8 plus how many faces? 6. Contribution is 1 by 2. So this is 1, this is 3. So this is 1 plus 3 equals to 4. Alright, so C is the correct answer. Very easy. Now coming back to this question. And we have to calculate the angle between the two planes. Between these two planes, Miller indices have been given 110 and 111 in a simple cubic. And I have already made a dedicated video to figure out the angle between the two planes. You can check that video out there. I think I included this question in the video itself. But still, those who don't know, angle can be calculated by cos theta equals to, this is h1, h2, this is h1, this is h2, plus k1, k2, plus l1, l2, divided by root h1 square plus k1 square plus L1 square multiplied by again root H2 square plus K2 square plus L2 square. So again just put the values. This is H1, this is H2, this is K1, this is K2, this is L1 and this is L2. When you will calculate, then the theta will come out to be around 35 degrees. But you will say that theta is here, 35 is not answer. Yes, exactly, this question was wrong options were given by the CSIR in that examination. So even if you have calculated any of the value, you would have got the full marks, all right, because the question is incorrect. In fact, the options are incorrect. So let's jump to the another question. And this question is based on the Bragg's equation. Alright, we have been given a simple cubic, alright, and Miller indices have been given 110. This is H, K, L, alright, and the order is, this is first order, and the unit cell side is given as 3.238. This is the value of A equals to 3.2 Armstrong, alright. And the wavelength have been given as 2.29. Now what is the Bragg equation? Bragg equation is nothing but 2d sin theta equals to n lambda. Alright, this is Bragg's equation. This is Bragg's equation. Alright, don't place a first of here. No, that's a different thing. This is, many of the people write it as this Bragg's equation. No, this is incorrect. This is a correct way of writing. I will tell this thing when I will take this Bragg equation, the whole derivation, how it comes. Basically, Bragg told that the path difference will be a integral wavelength of the integral multiple of the wavelength. Alright. So this is path difference, 2d sin theta. Okay, but we are not concerned about these parameters. For solving this question, we have how much? This lambda has been given. Lambda equals to 2.29 Armstrong. Alright, but what we have to calculate is angle. Angle means theta. Alright, so this is interplanar distance. This is Bragg's angle theta. This is n is the order. Alright. This is order, which have been given as 1. First order. N equals to 1. This is wavelength. Alright. Now solve lambda we have already written. A is given as, sorry, with a unit cell of side. Now see, don't get confused. Side has been given, but we will use in a certain way. How? We will have to write the full-fledged formula of D here. How? I will let you know. First, write the given data. A equals to 3.238 Armstrong. Now, we have been given N equals to 1, first order. What else we have been given? I think this is the all data we have been given. And we have to calculate the theta. Now, this is 2d sin theta equals to n lambda. So write 2d. I have already told you for cubic it is a upon root h square plus k square plus l square. 2d sin theta. This is sin theta equals to n lambda. N is 1 and lambda have been given as 2.29 Armstrong. Alright. Now write 2, this A value is given as 3.238 upon root, this is HKL, see here, HKL, so write here 1 square plus 1 square plus 0 square, this is sine theta equals to, this is 2.29 Armstrong. Are you getting my point? That means sine theta equals to 2.29. Alright, this is in multiplication, so it will here in division. So 2, and this is how much? Root 2. So right here, root 2. Alright, that means sine theta equals to 2.29 into this is 1.4 and upon 2. Are you getting my point? So when you will solve that, it will become theta equals to sine inverse of this something value, right? So theta will become 30 degrees. So option 1 is the correct answer, right? And you will say that in the CSIR examination, we are calculators are not allowed. But if you can do the rough calculation, say this is 2.29 into root 2. Sorry, here this is value is also there. So this is 2 into 3.238, right? This is 3.238. So let's say if you divide it by, this is 14. So this is 0.7. And when you will multiply 0.7 into 2.2 something, that means 7 2s are 14. This value will come around 1.5. And here in the denominator, we have 3.2. So it is almost around 1 by 2. And 1 by 2 value comes at the angle of theta of 30 degrees for sine. Alright. So by this thing, you can easily calculate. Okay. CSIR generally gives easy calculation like this, so that the need of the calculator is not there. Alright. So theta will be around 30 degrees. Again, so this video is getting longer. So for the next time, thank you. And please subscribe to the channel. I will make a part 2 of this video where I will be dealing some more difficult questions. Okay. Thank you.